Hello everyone, welcome to Lectures by Aparna. Today we will discuss about network topology and some basic terminologies in it. Network topology is a graphical representation of electric circuits. It is used for analyzing complex electric circuits by converting them into network graphs. So network topology is also called network graph theory. Now consider a circuit like this. Here there is a voltage source Vs, a current source Is, two capacitors C1, C2, two resistors R1, R2 and an inductor L1. Now let us see how to draw the network graph of this circuit. Network graph that we will draw will consist of nodes and branches. So first let us identify the nodes in this circuit. Here there are four nodes: this, this, this and this. So this is node 1, this is node 2, this is node 3 and this is node 4. So just mark the nodes like this. Now to draw the network graph, note down the nodes. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. Let it be node 1, node 2, node 3 and node 4. Now we have to draw the branches. To draw the branches, replace the passive elements. Passive elements in the circuit with branches. Passive elements here are inductor, capacitor and resistor. So replace each of the passive elements with the branch. So here between node 1 and 2 there is an inductor. So you can draw a branch here. Then between node 2 and 3 there is R1. Between node 2 and 4 there is a capacitor. Between node 1 and 3 there is a capacitor. And between node 3 and 4 there is a resistance. So you can draw it like this. Now for the voltage source and current source, what will you do? For the voltage source, short circuit the voltage source. Place a short circuit in the place of this voltage source. So voltage source is coming between node 1 and node 4. So just short circuit it and it will become another branch. For the current source, you can open circuit it. It is coming between node 3 and node 4. Between node 3 and node 4, for current source you can open circuit it. So you don't have to draw anything. So the line segments in the graph will represent the branches corresponding to either passive elements or voltage sources. So in the graph drawn here, there are four nodes: 1, 2, 3 and 4. And how many branches? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 branches are there. Let us label those branches as A, B, C, D, E and F. So these are the four nodes and 6 branches of this graph. Now there are different types of network graphs. They are connected graphs and unconnected graphs. Then there is directed graph and undirected graph. So these are the different types of network graphs. Consider a graph like this. This is an unconnected graph because here not even a single branch is connected to this node 1. So node 1 becomes an isolated node. This is an unconnected graph. In a connected graph, there will be at least one branch connected to each node. No node will be left isolated. Such a graph is called a connected graph. This is a connected graph. Now next type is directed and undirected graph. This is a directed graph. In this, if the branches of a graph are connected with arrows, then the graph is called a directed graph or oriented graph. If it is not having the arrows, then it is called undirected or unoriented graph. So this is an unoriented graph or undirected graph, whereas this is a directed graph or oriented graph. Another term coming in network topology is subgraph. This subgraph. We get subgraphs by removing some nodes or branches in a given graph. Suppose this is a given graph. When you remove some of the nodes or some of the branches, you will get a subgraph like this. So here none of the nodes are removed. All nodes are present here, but some branches are removed from this graph. So this graph is the subgraph of this graph. Here number of branches is less than that in this graph. So we can say subgraph is a subset of this graph. So this graph is a subset of this graph. There are two types of subgraphs. They are tree and co-tree. First let us see a tree. Consider a connected subgraph like this. And this is the original graph. And this is the subgraph of this graph. It is called a connected subgraph because no nodes are left isolated. This subgraph contains all the four nodes of the graph and there is no loop present in it. Loop means it is not closed anywhere. In that case, you will call it a tree. So tree is a subgraph which have all nodes of the original graph, plus there will not be any loops present in it. So when a subgraph satisfies these two conditions, it will become a tree. Some other trees that you can draw for this graph are these. You can see that all these have four nodes, all four nodes of this graph, and none of them are having closed areas. So all these are the trees for this graph. The branch of a tree, is called twig. These are the branches of this tree. So D, E, F are the twigs of this tree. This is a tree and D, E, F are the twigs of this tree. The remaining branches that are not included in this tree. Which are the branches that are not included here? When you compare it with this original graph, you can see that branches A, B and C are not included in this. So when you combine those branches, see node 1, 2, 3 and node 4. The branches which are not included in this are B, C and A. This is a branch A, this is B and C. These will form a co-tree. These will form the co-tree corresponding to this tree. So this is the tree and this is the corresponding co-tree of this tree. Co-tree means complement of tree. So here A, B, C, these are the branches of this co-tree. Branches of a co-tree are called links or cords. So here A, B, C are the links of this co-tree. Now let us consider another tree. This is another tree of this graph. So B, C, E are the twigs of this tree. Now we have to draw the co-tree. 1, 2, 3 and 4 are the nodes. Draw the branches which are not included in this. So they are A, this is A, this is D and this is F. So this is a co-tree corresponding to this tree. When you combine all the links and twigs, you will get the branches of a graph. So when you look here, you can see that the dotted lines will represent the links and those shown in blue color lines, they represent the twigs. So number of links plus number of twigs is equal to number of branches. Number of branches, that is L plus T is equal to B. Let this be equation 1. Now number of twigs, T is equal to N minus 1, where N is a number of nodes in a graph. See here, there are 4 nodes in all these trees. So N is equal to 4. So number, what is the number of twigs? T is equal to N minus 1, or that is 4 minus 1, that is equal to 3. So in all these cases there are 3 twigs. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So the number of twigs is equal to N minus 1. T is equal to N minus 1. Let this be equation 2. Now substitute 2 in 1. So it will be L plus N minus 1 is equal to B, or you get L is equal to B minus N plus 1. So number of links is equal to B minus N plus 1. Some of the basic terms coming in network topology or network graph theory. If this video has helped you, please do subscribe to my channel and also like and share this video. Thank you.